Hi guys, let's say you are working on the exterior image and you have to populate some interiors. You have two choices. Spend hours or days designing the space, finding the right models, placing them into your interiors, adding lights and adjusting materials. Or you can do it all under 10 minutes using wParallax OSL maps. This video is sponsored by wParallax, which created a set of ready-to-use interior maps, which I will demonstrate in this video. This is what you get if you purchase one of their bundles. We have 15 interiors, 5 in each size. We can also choose a lower or higher resolution. On top of that, we have an example of how to use it with Reclone. If I zoom in, it seems like a normal flat texture. But if I start the rendering, everything changes and this flat texture becomes 3D. We see the left wall, but if I move around, we see the right wall. Now the ceiling. And the floor. Magic, isn't it? This method uses just a single polygon to show an entire room. It's all possible thanks to the OSL, Open Shading Language. The wParallax effect is often used in video games to optimize scene performance, and now we can use it in our projects. To sum up, it's easy to use and is a huge time saver. With this method, working in the file is smooth because an entire room is just one polygon, and as a result, the rendering is way faster. We also have two lighting versions for each map, night and day, which we can quickly switch here. We can control it even further. Here is the material, which I will explain later in the video. For now, I want to show you how we can control the map. We can change room depth with this setting. Window aspect has to be set based on the plane size. In this case, the plane aspect is 3:1, so the value has to be set to 3 here. To understand it better, let me show you what the EXR texture actually looks like. The map is square and is divided into 9 smaller squares. The course inside is reserved for walls, floor, and ceiling. It works the same way, like folding the box from the paper. While the squares in the corners are for additional assets, like furniture, people, or curtains. As I told you at the beginning, with wParallax, we get maps in different aspect ratios, but the EXR files are all squared. Here we have the long map for aspect ratio 3:1. If you look closer, you can see that the middle section is squeezed. This way, if we set the window aspect to 3 in the OSL map settings, the back wall will be de-squeezed to the original size. Hope you get that. Then we can disable some elements like walls, but also furniture, people, or curtains. That is the stuff placed on the corner squares of the map. On top of that, we can adjust the position of these elements. Now, let me show you how to add a room to a building. Let's say we want to add an interior space here. First, let's create a plane. You can see that the plane aspect ratio is about 3:1. This means we have to use a long map. I will choose this texture. Open the material editor and pick the material. Then, let's apply the material to the plane. All left to do is to place the plane behind the glass. Let's see how it looks rendered. Perfect! The perspective is changing nicely and it's really hard to tell if this is not a free space, even though usually we wouldn't be so close for this use case. We can add a material modifier to switch between night and day. Number 2 is for the day. Here is the night texture, and here is the day texture. We can switch the furniture off or adjust its position. We can also adjust the room's depth. As you can see, it's super straightforward, but at the same time, you still have some control to adjust the maps to your scene. wParallax has created 9 packs with ready-to-use maps, which you can purchase separately or in bundles. The value for money is insane if you think about the time it will save you. It is a perfect solution for office projects, buildings with retail spaces, or residential projects where you have to populate the rooms. They gave a special discount for our community. You will get 15% off with the code AVA15WP. The link will be in the description below the video. wParallax requires no plugins, however, the software and render engines must have OSL, which is the case in 3ds Max, Corona and V-Ray. wParallax was specifically made for the ArcVis community, which uses 3ds Max, Corona and V-Ray, however, it can also work in other software. If the software you use doesn't support OSL, there is a workaround. We can use boxes instead of planes. We can create them from scratch and unwrap them or use already made presets. Here is how it looks. Basically the same thing, but in 3D. We can also control the position of the furniture by moving the polygons. Next, let me show you how to create a material from scratch. I will start by creating a corona material, but the process is the same with V-Ray. Then, let's add the bitmap. Here we have to choose the image from the preview folder. I have a plane with an aspect ratio of 2 to 1, so I will use the medium map. I will apply the material. Next, let's add the OSL map. It doesn't look like the one I showed you before. This is because we have to add a script. Go to the OSL shader folder and choose the first script. And here it is. Then we have to load our EXR map. Connect the RGB output to the self-illumination input of the corona material. We have to change the self-illumination value as well. Set it to 1. Also, let's change the color to black. It doesn't affect the material as we use a map, but the preview will be nicer. Let's see how it looks. The map is flipped. To fix this, uncheck this option. Great! We can also add a day variation to this material. Copy the OSL map and change the texture to day. Now, let's add a multi-map texture and plug our OSL maps. We have to use the face material ID option. Lastly, add a material modifier. If we change the ID to 2, we will get the day variation. It is also possible to add people to each interior with an additional human opaque. In the pack, we Photoshop files for each map size. We are using a long map, so let's open the file with the letter L at the end. Here it is. You can see that the people are squeezed, which is correct for this size of map. I explained how it works before. Just select the people you like to add and copy them. Then open them up. Make sure you use the 3K version. Paste the people and place them in the bottom right corner. They will appear on the map like this. We have furniture on the side, so I will place them in the middle. Once you're happy with the position, save the file. If you want to create a 1K map, change the size and save the file. Let's load the new map into 3ds Max. Go to the map and load the one with people. Nothing happened, that's because the people layer is off. Turn it on here. Additionally, we can adjust the placement with this value. I I hope you liked this video. If you did, check out the wParallax, link in the description. If you want to learn all about architectural visualizations and animations, check out our online courses. Or watch more videos here on YouTube. Bye bye!